Okay, so today we are going to be making Atlas stones. So the Atlas stone is probably, in my opinion, the greatest tool there is for creating ultimate full body grappling strength. I love climbing large ropes. I like using large diameter ropes for multiple exercises, but simply just picking up a concrete ball off the ground and picking it onto your shoulder or doing whatever with it just creates vast amount of security of full body strength. Now, that's very close to a sandbag, but a sandbag still can be picked up more efficiently. A ball is extremely difficult. So I'll take you through a couple of steps of the process. All right, so this is one of the molds that I have. So today we're gonna be using basically, this is roughly a 100-pound mold. So depending on the type of concrete that I use, I will yield usually anywhere between a 100 to 120-pound ball right here. Now, I know some people have filled it up and then we've actually put weights on the inside, but understand that you're still taking away from the amount of volume of concrete, so it's not a drastic difference. You're just truly off better off buying a larger mold. Today I'll be making 110-pound mold, Atlas stone, and then I will move on next time, the next video, to make a 200-pound ball, which I will use on the outside of my shop, where I'll probably train here outdoors. So let's get to it. Okay, so the second step is you have to seal this in. Now, you just take zip ties and go all the way across, make it really, really tight, okay? You have to make it as tight as you can because you don't want the water to seep through right here. It's not a big deal. You just have a little bit more sanding to do afterwards. Now, I sprayed this on the inside before I closed it up and I sprayed a little bit more. This is silicone lubricant made by Blaster. You silicone the inside really, really well. You can pretty much use cooking spray or anything else. It really doesn't matter. But this just allows the concrete not to stick so much to the mold itself. It will come out regardless. What you'll have to do though is have probably a rougher surface, and you might end up having to use like a rough grit, 80 grit sandpaper to really kind of grind it down and smooth it out. All right? Okay, move on to the next step. Okay, so what I used was crack resistant commercial grade Quikrete. That's an 80-pound bag. I used one 80-pound bag and about a quarter of another. Now, I realized that I didn't have my drill mix with me. So you can do it by hand like I did. The only issue that you run into is the fact that you sometimes have the wrong ratio of water and you got some clumps in there. And so I kind of ran into a few issues like that. But I'm going to show you the final product. Okay, so this is what it looks like for right now. So basically what I did was I mixed a quarter of a bag at a time with water, mixed it by hand, and then slowly poured it in. Another thing I forgot today was my damn funnel, which it's not that big of a deal, but it just tends to spread out and fall all over the ball. So what I did was a quarter of a time, like I said, and then slowly worked my way until I finally got to the top. Now, once we get to the top right here, you want to keep shaking this ball and keep shaking this ball and keep shaking this ball to make sure all air is coming up. Plus, we want to make sure that we don't have a lot of water just with mortar. We want to make sure that we have a lot of rock and concrete as a whole inside. So as you can see right here, I've got a lot of pebbles. And so what I did was I shook, and then I would add pebbles to it, a real thick solution. And what it is, it push a lot of the excess water out, okay? Because that's not gonna make a ball, that's just eventually going to evaporate. So we wanna make sure it's very solid at the top. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna keep it here for about 48 hours, maybe less. You know, it's Louisiana, so it's starting to get hot. So it'll dry up pretty quick. I'll crack the mold, I'll show you what that looks like. We'll sand it down and we'll get lifted. Okay, it's been 48 hours. I went ahead and cut all the tabs off. Now it's a little stuck, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna take a rubber mallet, not a regular hammer, you're gonna fucking break the mold and tap it all the way around. You want it to release. So it's kind of starting to release up in here, as you can see right there, but sometimes it will leak through these cracks, which aggravates the shit out of me. I'm still trying to figure out a way to make it smooth. But you go in with a screwdriver and you just start popping it up. And then there you go. There is your Atlas stone. Now, you see this roughness right here? I had an issue with my mixing at the end. Not a big deal. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a grinder. I'm also gonna take some 80 grit sandpaper and I'm gonna break this stuff apart and smooth this out so that way it doesn't tear up my arms too bad when I pick it up. All right? So we'll go ahead and flip it over to the other side and we'll give it a couple more taps. So this one's gonna take a little bit longer to come undone. So let's see. Still don't wanna come up. A little tap, 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 taparoos. So I'll just keep tapping until I pop it off and then I'll smooth it out and I'll show you the finished product. Okay, so I used this grinder, grinded the ball down. It's a little rough, but that is because of the poor mixing job I did at the end. This looks bad, but you'd be amazed on how smooth it actually feels. Normally you could just use 180 grit sandpaper. For the most part, this ball part is pretty smooth. But the grinder pretty much knocked out all the rough edges. Perfectly fine, good for use. So there you go. That's how you make an Atlas stone. That's how you train for life. That's how you train for wrestling, jiu-jitsu. This will make you a man.